Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again on the lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And today we are going to discuss lecture number 101, steady state heat transfer in a slab. In the first unit, conduction heat transfer. So we will recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we discussed the derivation of heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates and simplified the equation for the different basic situations like one-dimensional steady state heat transfer in a slab without internal heat generation, one-dimensional steady state heat transfer in a slab with the internal heat generation, and one-dimensional unsteady state heat transfer in a slab without heat generation. So we simplified the general equation for different basic situations. And using the equation, we will solve certain conditions. First, we take the one-dimensional steady state heat transfer in a slab without internal heat generation. And the learning outcome for the today's lecture, the student will be able to develop equation for one-dimensional steady state heat transfer, heat conduction in a slab and a composite slab. And the student will be able to explain the electrical analogy for heat conduction, and the student will be able to define the thermal resistance, and the student will be able to solve problem in the composite slab. The situation here, it is one-dimensional steady state heat transfer in a slab without internal heat generation. First, let us write the general heat conduction equation for a slab. So this equation, dou square T by dou x square plus dou square T by dou y square plus dou square T by dou z square plus Q dot by K equal to 1 by alpha dou T by dou T. So this equation is applicable for three-dimensional unsteady state heat transfer in a slab with heat generation. So the first three parameters, that is for three-dimensional situation, and dou T by dou T for unsteady state condition, and the Q dot for the internal heat generation. Now situation here, one-dimensional steady state heat transfer in a slab without heat generation. One-dimensional, so when you take one-dimensional, we have to drop dou square T by dou y square and dou square T by dou z square. So these dou square T by dou y square and dou square T by dou z square are deleted, are equal to zero. Then without heat generation, so Q dot by K equal to zero. And it is steady state heat transfer. There is no change in the temperature or the heat transfer. There is no change in the heat transfer or temperature with respect to time. So dou T by dou T equal to zero. So what is left out? The governing equation for the defined situation is dou square T by dou x square equal to zero. So here the temperature is dependent variable, x is the independent variable, there is only one variable, so we can write as dou square T by dou x square equal to zero. And this equation is applicable to a slab. So like this, we consider a slab. We take heat transfer only in the x direction. The slab of length L, on the left hand side x equal to 0 and t equal to t1, and right hand side x equal to L and t equal to t2. Now from the physical situation, the boundary conditions are t equal to t1 at x equal to 0 and t equal to t2 at x equal to L. So this is the governing equation for this situation, for the defined situation, and these are all the boundary conditions. Now we have to solve this differential equation within the boundary conditions and to find out the temperature distribution and the heat transfer. That is what the objective. So we have to find out the temperature distribution within the slab. So the temperature distribution means how the temperature is varying in the x direction from 0 to L at different values of x. For example, x equal to 0 here, x equal to L here. So in between, you take any value of x, you have to calculate the temperature. For you look at the line here, T1 is higher, T2 is lower, it is decreasing. So it is a linear equation, linear relationship exists here. So what is the temperature at different points of the x? That is what the temperature distribution. We will see how to do the mathematical derivation. So we have dou square t by dou x square equal to 0. Integrating first time, we will get dou t dt by dx equal to c1. Integrating again, t equal to c1x plus c2. So this is the temperature distribution equation. T equal to c1x plus c2. But there are two constants, c1 and c2. We have to find the values of the constant using the boundary conditions. So what are the boundary conditions? So x equal to 0, t equal to t1. X equal to L, T equal to T2. So I take the first boundary condition, X equal to 0, T equal to T1. So T1 equal to C1 into 0 plus C2, that gives T1 equal to C2. So C2 equal to T1, the constant C2 equal to T1. We take the second boundary condition, T equal to T2 at X equal to L. So T2 plus equal to C1 into L plus C2, and substitute for C2 from the previous value. So T2 equal to C1 into L plus T1, rearranging the terms, C1 equal to T2 minus T1 divided by L. So C2 equal to T1, C1 equal to T2 minus T1 divided by L, and substitute here. So we'll get the temperature distribution, T equal to C1 equal to T2 minus T1 divided by L into X plus T2. I rearrange here, so T equal to T2 minus T1 into X by L plus T2. So that is the temperature distribution equation. So using this, you can find out the temperature at any value of X. Look at the right hand side. We have the T1 is a temperature on the left side. T2 is the temperature on the right side. L is the length of the slab. The only variable is X and T. So T is a function of X. So when you substitute different values of X, you will get the temperature at that particular position. So this is what called as temperature distribution equation for a simple slab. Then the rate of heat transfer. So from the Fourier law of heat conduction, Q equal to minus K into dT by dx at x equal to L. So what is heat transfer to the right side, from left side to the right side? So at x equal to L here, so we have already dT by dx equal to C1. dT by dx equal to C1. So Q equal to minus K into C1. So equal to minus K into substituting for C1, this is T2 minus T1 divided by L. So I have to, there is a negative sign here, I have to drop the negative sign. So you take the direction, change in the direction. So Q equal to minus KA T1 minus T2 divided by L. So this is the heat transfer. So KA into T1 minus T2 divided by L is the heat transfer in the one-dimensional slab. And I write this equation in this fashion. So Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by L by KA. So numerator is the temperature difference and denominator is L by KA. So this is the heat transfer in the one-dimensional slab. Now we take the electrical circuit. So this is a simple electrical circuit what you studied earlier. So small current flow circuit with a resistance R, V1, V2 are the potential voltage and I is the current flow. And R is the resistance. So we know that I equal to V1 minus V2 divided by R. So V1 minus V2 is called as potential difference or the voltage difference divided by the electrical resistance. So this is a simple, very simple electrical circuit. Now we use the electrical analogy in the heat conduction or the heat transfer. We take the small circuit. T1 is the temperature on the left side. T2 is the temperature on the right side. So there is heat transfer Q. And there is a resistance. That resistance is called as thermal resistance. So for this situation, the Q already we have derived. Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by L by KA. So the numerator is called as temperature difference and denominator is called as thermal resistance comparing with the electrical circuit. So I equal to V1 minus V2 divided by R, which is potential difference divided by the electrical resistance. Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by L by Ka, which is the thermal resistance. So the thermal resistance equal to L by Ka. The unit is Kelvin by watts or degree Celsius by watts. So what is the advantage? What is the advantage of the electrical analogy? We studied in the electrical engineering the resistance in series, resistance in parallel. So the electrical technique, the technique will be applicable for heat transfer calculation when you have the resistance are in series and parallel. Thermal resistance are series in parallel. So in many of the cases, we are not going to take a single slab. So we are going to take a combination of different slab. So in that situation, the electrical analogy will be very much useful to solve the problem easily. So you just remember what is thermal resistance, which is L by K. Now you take this situation, composite slab. There are three slabs joined together, attached together, of different material. So L1, slab 1, slab 2 and slab 3. L1 is the thickness of the slab 1, K1 is the thermal conductivity of the slab 1, and L2 is the thickness of the slab 2, and K2 is the thermal conductivity of the slab 2, L3 is the thickness of slab 3, and K3 is the thermal conductivity of the slab 3, this material. So we have this situation, this is called as composite slab. So this situation which is available in many of the heat transfer situations. For example, you take a metallurgical furnace. Inside the metallurgical furnace, you have a fire clay lining. And the entire metallurgical furnace is covered with a sheet metal, shell, steel. Now there are two layers. The outer layer is steel and the inner layer is fire clay lining. Similarly, in the boiler, there is insulation, outer layer covered with the steel. So the composite slab is very common in heat transfer situation. So that is why we require the electrical analogy concept to solve the problem easily. Now the first slab, it offers a resistance L1 by K1 into A. So look at this equation, L by Ka, and here L1 by K1 into A. A is the heat transfer normal to the area, normal to the heat transfer, which is common. And R2, resistance R2 equal to L2 by K2 into A. And resistance R3 equal to L3 by K3 into A. So this is the circuit, thermal circuit for the composite slab. T1 is the temperature on the left side. T2 is the temperature, intermediate temperature between slab 1 and slab 2. And T3 is the intermediate temperature between the slab 2 and slab 3. And T4 is the outermost temperature, T4 here. Now in this situation, the heat transfer, it is easily calculated. So heat transfer equal to the potential difference T1 minus T4 divided by sum of all the resistances. So R1 plus R2 plus R3. So it is very easy now. So if we know the outer temperature and the extreme temperatures T1 and T4, so you can substitute T1, T4, and you can calculate from the property R1 and R2, you can calculate the heat transfer. Suppose you want to calculate the intermediate temperature. Now we have to take this temperature difference divided by the corresponding resistance. For example, Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1, or Q equal to T2 minus T3 divided by R2, and Q equal to T3 minus T4 divided by R3. So using that, you can calculate. So Q equal to the same heat transfer equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1 for the first slab. The same amount of heat is transferred from left side to right side. So the Q2 equal, second slab T2 minus T3 divided by R2, and third slab T3 minus T4 divided by R3. So this is the advantage of the electrical analogy concept in the heat transfer calculations. You take another situation, again the composite slab with the convection on both sides. The same situation, you take the same slab, three slabs, but here you have some atmospheric air, and left side, right side, you have the hot gases, like your boiler wall of the boiler, inside the boiler wall, inside the boiler, the hot gas are circulated, outside the boiler, you have the atmospheric air. Now there is a heat, there is a possibility of heat transfer from the inside the boiler to the outside of the boiler, so because of the temperature difference. Now we have the different layers, insulating layer to minimize the heat loss. So that is what the situation. So hot gases are on the left side, we have the different layers for insulation, and the atmospheric air is outside. So to prevent the heat transfer or to minimize the heat transfer, we have to have the thickness of insulation. The same situation, and here you have the convection resistance, and here you have the convection resistance. Now the resistance are, so the T infinity one is the temperature here, the first resistance due to the convection, second resistance due to the slab, third resistance again second, this resistance R2 is again the slab 2, and R3 again slab 3, and R4 due to the convection. Now the convection resistance equal to 1 by H1 into A. So H1 is the heat transfer coefficient on the left side, and A is the surface area, area normal to the heat transfer. R1 equal to L1 by K1 into A, R2 equal to L2 by K2 into A, and R3 equal to L3 by K3 into A, and again the convection resistance equal to 1 by H2 into A. So once you know the resistance values, you calculate the resistance values, then you can calculate the heat transfer, net of heat transfer equal to Q equal to, again the temperature difference, extreme temperature difference, T infinity 1 minus T infinity 2 divided by all the resistances, sum of all the resistances, and again the intermediate temperature you can calculate taking a particular slab or the convection. So Q equal to T infinity 1 minus T1 divided by RO, which is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1, which is equal to T2 minus T2 divided by R2, equal to T3 minus T4 divided by R3, equal to T4 minus T infinity divided by R4. So using the equation, we can calculate the intermediate temperature and the rate of heat transfer. And we take this situation. So the R1, we have the parallel, in the previous examples, we have the resistance in series. So here we have the resistance in the parallel. So this R1 is first resistance, and here we have the two resistances in parallel, R2 and R3. So here again R4 is one resistance, and R5, R6, R7, they are in parallel situation. So this is the electrical circuit. So when the resistance are in parallel, so we have to calculate the equivalent resistances. So you calculate R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7, all the resistance values from the thermal conductivity and the thickness of the slab, area of the slab. Then you calculate the equivalent resistance, 1 by R23 equal to 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3, and 1 by R56 equal to 1 by R5 plus 1 by R6 plus 1 by R7. So once you have the equivalent resistances, you can calculate the heat transfer. So Q equal to the extreme temperature difference. So Q equal to T1 minus T5 divided by R1 plus R23 plus R4 plus R567. And again, you can calculate the intermediate temperature with respect to the arrangement of the resistances in parallel. So Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1, which is equal to T2 minus T3 divided by R23, equal to T3 minus T4 divided by R4, equals T4 minus T5 divided by R5, 6, 7. So this is how you have to use the electrical resistance concept for solving the heat transfer problem. And we will solve few problems in this lecture, or two problems in this lecture. And before we solve the problem, we just recall theory what we discussed earlier. So the important concept here, first you write down the governing equation for one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a slab. So from your memory, whatever you understood from the previous 10 minutes, so you write down the governing equation for one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a slab. So if your answer is this, d square t by d x square equal to 0, you are correct. And you write the equation for thermal resistance. For conduction heat transfer, you write the equation for thermal resistance. If your answer is this, thermal resistance equal to L by Ka, and you are correct. So L by Ka is the thermal resistance for the conduction heat transfer. Now we take the first example. furnace wall is made up of three layers of thickness 25 centimeter, 10 centimeter, and 15 centimeter. And this is the given data. So L1 equal to 0.25 meter, L2 equal to 0.1 meter, and L3 equal to 0.15 meter. With thermal conductivity 1.65 K and 9.2 watts per meter Kelvin. So K1 equal to 1.65, K2 equal to unknown K, and K3 equal to 9.2 watts per meter Kelvin. The inside is exposed to hot gases at 1250 degrees Celsius. So inside is exposed to hot gas at 1250 degrees Celsius with the convection coefficient of 25. 25 watts per meter square Kelvin is the convection coefficient. The inside surface is at 1100 degrees Celsius. So T1. So this surface T1 here, it is 1100 degrees Celsius. The outside surface is exposed to air at 25 degrees Celsius. So here it is air at 25 degrees Celsius. With the convection coefficient 12 watts per meter square Kelvin. Now you have to determine the unknown thermal conductivity, overall heat transfer coefficient, and all the surface temperatures. So this is the situation. So write down the, understand the problem and draw the diagram. The situation, simple diagram, use the pencil. You write down the parameter L1, K1, R1. L2, K2, R2 and L3, K3, R3. This is slab 1, slab 2, three, slab 3. Now, there are five resistances. Resistance left side extreme, convection resistance, slab 1 resistance, slab 2 resistance and slab 3 resistance, and again convection resistance due to the air. Now, the five resistances are given here. So, Ri is the inside convection resistance and here is the temperature is Ti. R1 is the slab resistance. R2 is the slab resistance, R3 is the slab resistance for the slab 3, and RO is the convection resistance for the air. So, this is the circuit diagram. Now, the first duty here in the convection heat transfer, you have to calculate the resistance values of the resistances. So, we take the values of the resistance, Ri, convection resistance equal to 1 by A into Hi. So, area is not given, we can take 1 meter square. So, 1 by 25 equal to 0.04 degrees Celsius per watt. R1, L1 by A into K1. So, L1 equal to 0.25, thermal conductivity is 1.65, 0.1515 degrees Celsius per watt. R2, L2 by A into K2, and K2 value is unknown, it is given as K. So, 0.1 divided by K, 0.1 divided by K. And R3 equal to L3 by A into K3, which is 0.15 divided by 9.2, which is 0.0163. degrees Celsius per watt, and RO, outside convection resistance, which is 1 by A into HO equal to 1 by 12 equal to 0.083 degrees Celsius by watts. Now, there is one unknown resistance. R2 is unknown, so we cannot use the combined equation, but instead, this is the resistance circuit for convenience. We reproduce the resistance circuit here again. Now, we calculate the rate of heat transfer. So, here, Q equal to Ti minus T1. T1 value is also given. Inside surface temperature is also given. So, using the two temperatures, you can calculate the heat transfer. So, Ti minus T1 divided by Ri, that is equal to 1250 minus 1100 divided by 0.04 equal to 3750 watts. So, this is the heat transfer. So, once you know the heat transfer, we can calculate the intermediate temperature. So, here Ti 1250 degrees Celsius, T1 1100 degrees Celsius. Now, we calculate T2. So, Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1. So, T1 minus T2 divided by R1. So, from here T2 equal to T1 minus Q into R1. So, T1 is 1100 degrees Celsius minus Q equal to 3750 into 0.1515. That leads to T2 equal to 531.8 degrees Celsius. So, here the temperature is 531.8 degrees Celsius. The R2 value is not known, so we cannot proceed in the right side. We go back to the left side. Now, Q equal to T4 minus TO divided by RO. You take the last condition. So, from this condition, T4 equal to TO plus Q into RO. Rearranging the term, T4 equal to TO plus Q into RO. So, T4 equal to 25 plus 3750 into 0.083, which is 337.4 degrees Celsius. So, T4 equal to 337.4 degrees Celsius. Now, from here, you can calculate T3. So, T3 equal to, so Q equal to T3 minus T4 divided by R3. So T3 equal to T4 plus Q into R3, which is equal to 337.4 plus 3750 into 0.0163, which is 398.5 degree Celsius. So we have calculated, already given Ti equal to 1250, T1 equal to 1100, T2 equal to 531.8, T3 equal to 398.5, and T4 equal to 337.4, and TO equal to 25 degree Celsius. That is what the values given. Now, the unknown thermal conductivity. Already we have R2 equal to 0.1 divided by K, which is T2 minus T3 divided by Q. From the circuit, this is T2 minus T3 divided by Q. So, substituting all the values, R2 equal to 0.0355. So, from here, K equal to 0.1 divided by 0.0355. That is equal to 2.82 watts per meter Kelvin. So, the unknown thermal conductivity is 2.82 watts per meter Kelvin. Now, the overall heat transfer coefficient. So, first you calculate the all the sum of the resistances, Ri plus R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus RO. Substitute the values, this is equal to 0.3263. You calculate R into A. So, A equal to area normal to heat transfer, which is 1 here. So, R into A equal to 0.3263. And the overall heat transfer coefficient is defined as U equal to 1 by R into A, which is 1 by 0.3263, which is 3.06 watts per meter square Kelvin. So, this is the answer. And this equation you just remember right now, and this will, we will discuss about the U value later in the heat exchanger design, because the overall heat transfer coefficient is very much useful or used in the heat exchanger design. And the answers for the problem are, the unknown thermal conductivity K2 equal to 2.82 watts per meter Kelvin, and overall heat transfer coefficient is 3.06 watts per meter square Kelvin, and unknown temperatures are T2 equal to 531.8, T3 equal to 398.5, and T4 equal to 337.4 degree Celsius. We take another example, and a furnace wall consists of three layers. The inner layer of 10 centimeter thick made of fire brick of thermal conductivity of 1.04 watts per meter Kelvin, and the intermediate layer of 25 centimeter thickness L2 equal to 0.25 of masonry brick of thermal conductivity 0.69, so K2 equal to 0.69, followed by 5 cm thick concrete wall, so L3 equal to 0.05 meter, and thermal conductivity is 1.37 watts per meter Kelvin. So K1 equal to 1.04 watts per meter Kelvin, K2 equal to 0.69 watts per meter Kelvin, K3 equal to 1.37 watts per meter Kelvin, L1 equal to 0.1 meter, L2 equal to 0.25 meter, L3 equal to 0.05 meter, and when the furnace wall, the inside temperature is 18 degrees Celsius, T1 equal to 18 degrees Celsius, and the outer surface is 50 degrees Celsius, where T4 equal to 50 degrees Celsius. So, there are only three resistances. We take the three resistances R1, R2, R3. T1 is a temperature extreme left side, T4 is temperature on the outermost wall, and T2, T3 are the intermediate temperatures. So, as we said earlier, first, we have to calculate thermal resistances. R1 equal to L1 by A into K1, which is 0.1 divided by 1.04, 0.096. R2 equal to L2 by A into K2, so 0.25 divided by 0.69, which is equal to 0.362. R3 equal to L3 by K3, which is 0.05 divided by 1.37, which is 0.0367. Now, the rate of heat transfer Q equal to T1 minus T4 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3, which is 800 minus 50 divided by 0.096 plus 0.362 plus 0.0365, which is 1516.7 watts. Now, the intermediate temperature, so Q equal to T1 minus T2 divided by R1, so T2 equal to T1 minus Q into R1, so T2 equal to 800 minus 1516.7 into 0.096. which is 654.4 degree Celsius, and for calculating T3, Q equal to T3 minus T4 divided by R3, which is equal, from here T3 equal to T4 plus Q minus R3, so T3 equal to 50 plus 1516.7 into 0.0365, which is 105.636 degree Celsius. So the answers are, rate of heat transfer equal to 1516.7 watts, and the surface temperature T2 equal to 654.4 degrees Celsius and T3 equal to 105.36 degrees Celsius. So we stop here. So these are all the reference books for the preparation of the notes, and you follow the books, you refer to the book, it will be useful, and I have published a book on the subject. You can refer to it for further problem on this topic. So thank you. I will meet again, and if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID. I will reply sincerely.